Hello everyone, how are you? I hope you will be fit and fine at home. Okay, welcome in DP class. Our third chapter is going on gender, religion and caste. First topic, we have discussed gender differences in the field of politics regarding the women also. Now we will see third differences, religion, communications and politics. First, we know religious diversity is widespread in the world today. Many countries including India has many religions. Yani we are also having many types of religions we are following here. Religion differences, yani unlike gender differences, religious differences are also expressed in the politics. Not only gender differences seen in the politics, even religious differences are also expressed in politics. Let us see some few points. Gandhiji used to say that religion cannot be separated from politics. According to Gandhiji, from the politics we cannot separate the religion. He didn't mean like they. Gandhiji didn't talk about any particular religion, Hindu, Muslim, Christian, Sikh. No. He believed that politics must be guided. Gandhiji wanted to say that politics must be guided. How the politics should be followed by ethics. Ethics means moral principles. We know everyone, every religion is having the good principles, good values drawn from religion. It means we should take some good ideas from the religion. And these ideas and good values we should inculcate in the politics field. ताकि हम अपनी राजनीति को भी क्या बना सके, इन मोरल सिद्धांतों को लेकर साफ सुथरी राजनीति बना सके, अकॉर्डिंग टू गांधी जी. नाउ सेकंड पॉइंट, ह्यूमन राइट्स. ह्यूमन राइट्स सेज दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द विक्टिम्स ऑफ कम्युनल राइट्स, मोस्ट ऑफ द विक्टिम्स ऑफ कम्युनल राइट्स मतलब फाइट बिटवीन टू रिलीजियस पीपल आर पीपल फ्रॉम रिलीजियस माइनॉरिटीज. According to the human rights, say that most of the victims in our country of communal rights, and when two religious people fighting to each other, two communities, or then who has affected that? Religious minorities. It means those religions are in less in number. Yani people are less in number. They have demanded. So it means religious minorities peoples, what they are demanding? They have demanded that government take some special steps to protect religious minorities. So, yani ki according to human rights, what they are demanding? Ki government should take some steps so they can improve their conditions from the majority group of people. Now third, women, religion and politics. Women's movement, we have already seen feminist movement they have started, suffrage movement they have started, have said that according to that family laws in marriage, divorce, adoptions, etc. of all religions discriminate against women. For example, we can see teen talaq, and in the earlier times men can do marriages, but now it is not applicable. But these, if we are taking two examples, so we are saying that women are discriminating. So what they are demanding? They have demanded that the government take some special steps to protect religious minorities. And what they have demanded, they want the equitable, and they want the equal share in the society. There should be no discrimination. So it means religion and politics is having the close relationship. Those who have had political power, and those who are having the political power, should sometimes to be regulate the practice of religion. Sometimes to be regulate the practice of religion so as to prevent discriminations and oppressions. It means in the political field, we should give the chance to each and every religion. ताकि उनको ये नहीं लगे कि एक religion को कि हमारे साथ discrimination हो रहा है या हमारे ऊपर oppressions हो रहा है जिसको हम proper equality नहीं दे पा रहे. तो they treat, what they want to say here, they treat every religion equally. Now we will discuss about next topic, communism. Now we will discuss next topic, communism. When communism occurs, the problem of communism occurs when beliefs of one religion are presented as to those of अदर रिलीजन, इट मीन्स व्हेन वन रिलीजन इज थिंकिंग कि वी आर मोर सुपीरियर कंपेरेटिव टू द अदर रिलीजन, द प्रॉब्लम बिगिंस व्हेन रिलीजन इज प्रेजेंटेड सुपीरियर ऑफ दोज ऑफ अदर रिलीजन. तो कम्युनिटी मतलब संप्रदाय पर, व्हेन इट क्रिएटेड व्हेन वन रिलीजन इज थिंकिंग कि वी आर मोर सुपीरियर कंपेरेटिवली टू द अदर रिलीजन, तो दैट प्रॉब्लम स्टार्ट. What is communal politics? Political is based on religion. We know very well our politics is based on the religion for attaining short-term selfish goals. During the rallies, we can see political leaders giving their speech and they are saying ki you should give cast your vote because we belong to that particular community, particular religion, and for the short term, for their selfish goal, yani ki apne swarth ko sidh karne ke liye. पॉलिटिकल लीडर्स किसको बेवकूफ बनाते हैं? बोली वाली जनता को, धर्म के आधार पर वोट लेने के लिए. और हम लोग धर्म के आधार पर जो आम लोग हैं वो बट जाते हैं कि हम ये सोचते हैं कि जो हमारे पॉलिटिकल लीडर्स जो बात बोल रहे हैं वो ही हमारे लिए सही है, हमें उसी बेसिस पर हमारे वोट को डालना चाहिए. नाउ कम्युनल थिंकिंग क्या है? द फॉलोअर ऑफ ए पर्टिकुलर रिलीजन मस्ट बिलोंग टू वन कम्युनिटी, यानी कि द फॉलोअर ऑफ ए पर्टिकुलर रिलीजन, यानी कि इफ यू आर फॉलोइंग एनी वन पर्टिकुलर रिलीजन तो मस्ट बिलोंग टू वन कम्युनिटी, यानी कि दे बिलोंग टू वन पर्टिकुलर कम्युनिटी. इन इट्स एक्सट्रीम फॉर्म, और ये कब ज्यादा हो जाता है कम्युनिज्म, लीड्स टू द बिलीफ दैट पीपल बिलोंगिंग टू डिफरेंट रिलीजन, इन आवर कंट्री वी सी वी आर फॉलोइंग द डिफरेंट रिलीजन, कैन नॉट लिव एज इक्वल सिटीजन विद इन वन नेशन. समटाइम्स क्या करेंगे, व्हेन कम्युनिज्म टेक द एक्सट्रीम फॉर्म, व्हेन डिफरेंट रिलीजन पीपल्स वर सेइंग कि वी कैन नॉट लिव टूगेदर इन आवर वन कंट्री एंड इन वन नेशन, वी कैन नॉट लिव इक्वली. कम्युनिज्म कैन टेक वेरियस फॉर्म इन पॉलिटिक्स, यानी कि हाउ द कम्युनिज्म टेक वेरियस फॉर्म्स इन द पॉलिटिक्स. रिलीजियस कम्युनिटीज बिलीविंग सुपीरियर देन अदर्स, यानी कि रिलीजियस कम्युनिटीज थिंकिंग कि वी आर द सुपीरियर टू द अदर रिलीजन. फॉर दोज हु बिलोंग टू मेजोरिटी कम्युनिटी, दिस टेक फॉर्म ऑफ द मेजोरिटेरियन डोमिनेंस. वी नो वेरी वेल मेजोरिटेरियन मतलब व्हेन ए ग्रुप, या वी कैन से दैट गवर्नमेंट या एनी पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज गेन द मेजोरिटी, दे वॉन्ट टू रूल द कंट्री, वट एवर दे वॉन्ट टू डू, दे डोंट रिस्पेक्ट द माइनॉरिटी ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल. द सेम वे रिलीजियस मेजोरिटी ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल आर ऑल्सो डूइंग द सेम, दे वर ऑल्सो रूलिंग द कंट्री अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर ओन वेज, दे डोंट टेक केयर द माइनॉरिटी रिलीजियस ग्रुप पीपल. So it means when minority group of people what they are thinking ki we are separate from the political unit, yani ki we are totally separated from the political arena, ki isme hamare political rajniti mein hamari koi value nahi, kyunki yahan to kisko importance di ja rahi hai, majority jo dominance mein hai usi ko supremacy mil rahi hai, usi ko sab kuch. Now third point, political mobilization. Political mobilization means for gaining the support of the ordinary peoples. Not now, in the olden days also political leaders were using the scare symbols, religious leaders, emotional appeal and plain fear also they are showing. But they want to see here ki aap hum we are belongs to that particular religion, so you should cast to your vote to that particular religion candidate. To yani ki wo hame emotionally appeal bhi karte hain कि हमारी भावनाओं के साथ कि भी आप इस रिलीजन से बिलोंग करते हैं, अच्छा आप हमें नहीं वोट डाल रहे हो और दूसरे धर्म के लोगों को वोट डाल रहे हो, वो बात गलत है. तो इससे हम क्या हो जाते हैं, इमोशनली अटैचमेंट हो जाते हैं उस कैंडिडेट के साथ कि हाँ भी हमें इसी को वोट डालना चाहिए, क्यों, क्योंकि ये हमारे रिलीजन से बिलोंग करता है. और प्लेन फियर मतलब हमारे मन में डर बिठा देते हैं, अगर हमने दूसरी रिलीजन के कैंडिडेट को वोट डाला तो देखो कितना गलत होगा. तो यानी कि फॉर पॉलिटिकल मोबिलाइजेशन यानी कि फॉर विनिंग द इलेक्शन, नाउ द पॉलिटिकल लीडर्स दे आर यूजिंग स्केयर सिंबल, उस रिलीजन से रिलेटेड किसी धार्मिक गुरु को बुलाना, उनके उपदेश दिलवाना ताकि लोग कैसे मोटिवेट हो उनकी तरफ, ज्यादा से ज्यादा मोटिवेट करने के लिए लोगों के लिए, सो दैट दे हैव यूजिंग दैट मेथड पॉलिटिकल मोबिलाइजेशन. नाउ कम्युनिज्म, व्हेन द कम्युनिज्म टेक द वर्स्ट फॉर्म, या वी कैन से दैट टेक द मास्क, वी कैन सी द example of India and Pakistan. When our country India divided into two parts, India and Pakistan, due to the partitions, that time many people died, mass scale में से when a large scale of people died, नरसंहार जिसको हम बोलते हैं, जब हमारा सांप्रदायवाद किस आधार पर हम डिवाइड हुए थे, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ रिलीजन, यानी कि those who believe in Hindu, they will live in the Hindu those who believe in the Pakistan, mostly Muslim religion, they went to Pakistan. So it means that time our country is divided on the basis of communisms. Thank you. Next topic, we will discuss secular state. Now we will discuss secular state. A state which has no official religion of its own. It means in our country, when we are making our constitution, so our constitution makers were aware with the challenge of communisms. That's why we have not given any special status to any one particular religion. That's why our country declared as a, matlab, there is no official religion. So there is no official religion, unlike in Sri Lanka, Buddhism religion followed. We know very well in the first chapter we have discussed in the power sharing. Sinhala speaker peoples, they have adopted which religion there? Buddhism. So it means what is the official religion there? Buddhism. And Pakistan followed by the which religion? Islam. Or in Britain, Christianity. But in our country, our constitution doesn't give any special status to any one particular religion. That's why our country is called, what is called? If there is no official religion, our country is called a secular state. According to that, our constitution was freedom to practice any religion to all communities. In our country, we are free. We can adopt any religion, we can profess, we can propagate. हम किसी भी धर्म को अपना सकते हैं, किसी भी धर्म का प्रचार कर सकते हैं. There is no prohibition. It prohibits discrimination on grounds of religion. यानी on the basis of religion, we cannot discrimination only on the basis of the religion. Prohibits. It is totally prohibited. पाबंदी है. किसी को धर्म के आधार पर किसी के साथ कोई भेदभाव नहीं कर सकते हैं. Third, constitution allows state to intervene. What is the meaning of intervene? To come in between. If constitution allows to any country, if religion matter happens, if any country in our country, if any religion matter happen in our country, so then who can come in between? Our state government can come and they can interfere. And according to the constitution has banned the act of untouchability. Our constitution has banned the untouchability, जिसको बोलते थे छुआ छाप प्रथा, जो हमारे पुराने समय में चली आ रही थी. लोग धर्म के आधार पर, जाति के आधार पर लोगों से भेदभाव करते थे. ये हमने कौन से आर्टिकल के थ्रू बैन कर दिया इसको? आर्टिकल 17. अकॉर्डिंग टू आर्टिकल 17, untouchability has been removed, you're banned from the society. Now conclusions. Communism should be banished for proper progress of a country. And if we want to develop our country, then we totally, we should banish. Banish मतलब हमें इसको बिल्कुल finish कर देना चाहिए for the proper progress of a country. So we can done the in the proper way of the progress of our country. ताकि हम अपनी country की उन्नति कर सके, विकास कर सके in proper. अगर हम communism, अगर हम धर्म के आधार पर ही फंसे रहेंगे, खाली एक मैटर को लेकर चलेंगे, तो क्या हमारी कंट्री तरक्की कर सकती है, प्रोग्रेस कर सकती है, डेवलपमेंट हो सकता है हमारी कंट्री में क्या? नहीं. तो दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव वॉन्ट ही शुड बी वैनिश फॉर प्रॉपर प्रोग्रेस ऑफ आवर कंट्री. तो बड़ी का कंक्लूजन ऑफ सेकुलर स्टेट विच हैज नो ऑफिशियल रिलीजन ऑफ इट्स ओन. व्हेन आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन मेड, तो आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन मेकर्स वर अवेयर ऑफ दैट चैलेंज बिकॉज आवर कंट्री वॉज ए डाइवर्स कंट्री. Different religion, different caste. So that's why we have declared that there should be no official religion in our country. It is depend on our peoples. If they want to choose any religion on their own choice, they can choose. They can profess, propagate, they can spread any particular religion. There should be no foundation. So freedom to practice in our country, it is free. We can adopt any religion and not only in one particular community. It applicable for all the communities, they can adopt any religion. Third, it prohibits discrimination on grounds of religion. And on the basis of religion, we cannot discrimination. Or our constitution totally prohibited untouchability. Or that untouchability has been removed from which article? According to article 17. The conclusion, if we want to the proper progress of our country, so communism should be banished from the society. Now next topic we will discuss. Now we will discuss about the next topic, caste and politics. We have discussed about the three differences we are discussing: gender, religion and caste. We have completed gender, religion. Now we will see caste. We have already seen, unlike gender and religious differences, how the caste division is also prevalent in our society. So first we will see under and caste and politics, which type of inequalities were prevalent in the caste system. Under the caste system, we know either birth is divided among people on the basis of their caste. In the olden times, we can see on the basis of their caste, according to that work was divided. And he goldsmith, ka beta goldsmith ka hi kaam karega. Cobbler ka beta, cobbler ka hi kaam karega. So yani according to that divided on the basis of their caste. Occupations are passed from generations to generation. Yani dar peedhi dar, ye jo occupations tha wo chalta rehta tha usme. Members of the same caste are deemed to be from the same community. They are allowed to marry only within their community. Within their community means they can marry only within their particular caste. Caste system was based on discrimination. जो हमारा caste system था किस आधार पर था ये discrimination पर. They cannot even eat with the members of other caste. Even one caste people cannot eat other things from the other caste people. It means they can eat only particular only their own caste. So that was not good thing. So many political leaders and social reformers came forward. For example, Mahatma Gandhi, Jyotiba Phule, B.R. Ambedkar were to establish. Yani they wanted caste free society. Yani they wanted to a society. Which type of society they want to develop? There should be no inequalities in the caste related to the caste. Yani they wanted caste free society. Things have changed a lot now. How these system have changed due to economical development. Nowadays we are doing more and more progress. Many factories are opening, so many people are moving from one place to another place. That's why urbanization developed and growth of literacy rate. Literacy yani ki a person who can read and write. So yani ki nowadays our literacy rate is also increasing in the men and women. The old ideas of the caste system are breaking down. ओल्ड आइडिया जो हम पहले पुराने विचारों के जो चले आ रहे थे कास्ट सिस्टम का जो प्रचलन था वो धीरे धीरे क्या हो रहा है ब्रेक डाउन खत्म होते जा रहा है बट नाउ वी डोंट केयर मच व्हेन वी ट्रेवल ईट एटसेट्रा स्पेशली इन अर्बन एरिया जैसे आप लोग कहीं यात्रा कर रहे थे किसी से कोई लेना देना नहीं है वो कहाँ कौन बैठा हमारे साथ हम हमारे से आगे जब हम रेस्टोरेंट में खाना खा रहे थे अगली सीट पर हमसे कौन बैठे थे डोंट लोक केयर टेक केयर इवन इन द अर्बन एरिया वी ऑल्सो नो इन द अपार्टमेंट कि हमसे ऊपर वाली बिल्डिंग में कौन सी कास्ट के लोग रह रहे हैं इट मीन्स वी आर नॉट टेकिंग केयर नाउ अभी बट टोटली दैट कास्ट इनइक्वालिटीज नॉट डिसअपीयर फ्रॉम द सोसाइटीज वी आर सेइंग पीपल मैरी देयर ओन कास्ट वी आर सेइंग ना कि नाउ इंटर कास्ट मैरिजेज वी कैन डू नॉट प्रिवेलेंट टू मच इवन आज भी हम इसको अच्छा नहीं मानते इंटर कास्ट मैरिज को हमें सोचते हैं कि पीपल मैरी देयर ओन कास्ट कि हम ज्यादातर उसी को प्रेफरेंस देते हैं कि लोग अपनी ही कास्ट में शादी करें अगर कोई करता भी है तो हम उसके ऊपर एक क्वेश्चन मार्क लगा देते हैं क्या हमें अपनी कास्ट में लड़के और लड़कियां नहीं मिले व्हाई वी आर गोइंग इन द अंडर कास्ट तो अभी क्योंकि अभी हमारा आइडिया इतना भी डेवलप नहीं हुई हमारे विचार धीरे धीरे हम जा रहे हैं पर टोटली नहीं हुआ अभी चीज अनटचेबिलिटी हैज नॉट एंडेड कम्प्लीटली वी आर सेइंग कि अकॉर्डिंग टू द आर्टिकल 17 वी हैव टोटली रिमूव बैन अनटचेबिलिटी पर प्रैक्टिकली इट इज नॉट एंडेड completely so it means we have discussed here caste inequalities now in next topic we will discuss about the caste and politics